Today I'm going to talk about a powerful auto exposure mode on the Canon EOS-R, and I believe it's available for all the Canon R series mirrorless cameras. And this one is called the FV mode. When you're taking a picture and you want to get the right exposure, you have at your disposal four things that you can adjust to get that right exposure. The first one is your shutter speed. The second one is your aperture. The third one is your exposure compensation, and the fourth one is your ISO. By having full control of the four parameters that affect exposure, you also have full control of the other things that are affected by those parameters. So for example, you have your aperture, which affects your depth of field. So if you want to be able to be in control of your depth of field, you set your camera to aperture priority. You have your shutter speed, and shutter speed affects motion. So if you want to freeze motion, you have control of that shutter speed. And finally, you have control of your ISO if you want to control the amount of noise in your image. The cool thing about the FV mode is that it allows you to control all four of those parameters. Let me show you how FV mode works and how it can possibly replace all your other modes like shutter priority, aperture priority, manual, and automatic, because you can set your camera to all those different modes without leaving the FV mode. So on your EOS-R, all you do is you press mode at the top, and then you are presented with your shooting mode. Make sure you are in the photo mode, and then you just go and select FV. Now when you select FV, on the display you'll see at the bottom there are four items that I just talked about. The first one is your shutter speed, the second one is your aperture, third one is your exposure compensation, and the last one is ISO. Depending on how you're using the camera before, or if you've gone into FV mode before, when you switch the first time to FV mode, you might find that all the settings that I've talked about are in auto mode, and there'll be auto written on each of the boxes except the exposure compensation. Now when you press the shutter, you'll find that the values start changing, but they are underlined. When the values are underlined, it means that setting is in auto mode. For you to know which of these is selected, you will see an orange ring that represents the rear dial on your camera. And so when you move the rear dial, you can move from one parameter to the other. So you can move across from your shutter to your aperture, exposure compensation, and ISO, just like that. When the parameter is highlighted by that ring, then you can actually change the value of that parameter by moving your front dial. You can either move your front dial, or you can just tap on it on the touch screen and then adjust the parameter. Because you have access to all these four parameters, you can actually change which exposure mode you are in by simply changing which of them are in auto mode and which of them are in manual mode. So for example, like I said, when we started off, everything was in auto, so the camera will behave like it is in auto mode. If I want to quickly go into shutter priority, where I am actually controlling the shutter myself and everything else is in auto, all I need to do is to highlight the shutter and then change the value. Once the value is changed, that particular parameter is now in manual mode and you have control of that parameter, and everything else stays in auto. So now you are in shutter priority mode. So I can set my shutter to manual mode, and I can also set my ISO to manual mode. That puts me in the traditional shutter priority mode. To reset each of the parameters back to auto, all you do is you select it, click on it, and then drag all the way to the left back into auto position. Now on the R7 and other R series cameras, you can reset everything back to auto by simply holding down the trash button on the back of your camera for 1 second and letting go, and everything resets to auto. On the Canon EOS-R, you're supposed to be able to reset each of the parameters by simply using the cross keys at the back of the camera. Now for me, I've not been successful in either using the cross keys or the trash icon to reset everything to auto. So if you have tried it and it has worked on your Canon EOS-R, let me know in the comments so that I can correct whatever it is that it is not working for me. If I want to go into aperture priority, I just make sure everything else is in auto. I click on the aperture and then set my aperture the way I want it, that puts that aperture into manual mode and everything else stays in auto mode. The other thing I could do is set my exposure compensation to be controlled by the control ring at the front, go into your menu and assign exposure compensation to your control ring. And then all you have to do is to make sure that this switch on the side, you move it from focus to control. To go into fully manual mode, all I need to do is just select each of the parameters and change the value slightly, and everything goes into manual mode, and now you have fully manual mode. The FV mode is really powerful because it gives you access to those four parameters that help you in setting your exposure, and it also gives you the flexibility to be able to change from fully automatic to fully manual aperture priority, your shutter priority, your program mode, and you can do all this without even leaving that FV auto exposure mode. So try it out and see how it goes for you.